Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. In the previous video, we discussed about border, outline, and margin. So, practically, in this video, we learn about padding, dimensions, and layouts. Okay. So, now I am start discussing about padding. Before that, we need to save this file. padding.html. CSS padding.html. So now I am starting HTML CSS padding. So now style so now I am implementing the style p.1 border 1px solid red and background color yellow. So now padding top, some value we need to give. Similarly, padding right, also we give some value. Similarly, padding bottom, we need to give some value. So similarly, padding left, also we need to give some value. Okay. Similarly, here I am using paragraph tag. Okay, here CSS padding class 1. Okay, after saving this file, we need to run. So this is what exactly. So see the difference, this will be full width, so it will take like that. Okay, so now excuse me, now I am moving into dimensions. Same program, I will change the required things. So here I am using div. Okay, div width 500px, height 100px, and border 3px solid, some color will be assigned. So that is the hexa code will be used. Okay, so similarly I am using this as a div. Okay, div. Okay, so no CSS dimensions. Okay, now we need to replace that file. So this is the 500 and this is what exactly the dimensions are used. Now I am changing the width to max width. Excuse me. Okay, so I am changing the width to maximum width is 500. So that what I am doing is I am adding same text repeatedly. Same text is using. Okay, now you can see the difference. After this it will come under down. Okay, so previously that is not happened, it reaches the maximum. Here we fixed it automatically, it come under the down. Okay, this is what exactly. Now we are moving into the layouts concept. Okay. Now I am taking another new file for betterment. Okay. Firstly, save as. layout.html. Okay, so initially HTML layout. So here I need to apply styles. Okay, so in this span. So here I need to apply display block. Okay, so here span CSS layout. So after saving this, I want to go and run this file. So this is what exactly block. So now I am using second one is h1 dot hidden. Okay, so now visibility hidden. Okay, now I will take h1 CSS layout. Okay, after saving this file, while I am running it, so it displays the text. Now li display property inline. Okay, similarly I am using UL unordered list. Okay, under this we are using LIs. So this LI is 1 2 3. So I am writing 3. So you think that actually they are coming one by one, but it gives in single line. So when we are designing a menu, this will help you in line. Okay, so the next one is h1.hidden display is null. Okay, sorry, I changed this, hidden is null. So obviously there is no reflection. So the next things are very different relative. So what I am doing is position relative width 400px and height 200px and border 3px solid hash, same color is used, 73821. Okay, so similarly I am also implement absolute, both will be same things, small changes are done. So I will write here, then I will make it used in differently. Absolute, the position absolute, and top 80px, right 0px, and width 200px and height 100px एंड बॉर्डर 3px सॉलिड हैश 73AD21. ओके, सो दिस इज द रिक्वायरमेंट्स. नाउ आई विल डू इट हियर डू हियर. क्लास इज रिलेटिव. सो हियर आई एम राइटिंग css layout dimension dimensions. So similarly I am also write div class is absolute and same text will be right css layout dimensions. Okay, now I save this file and now I compile this file. So see the difference between these two boxes. Okay, I think this will come equally in the same line. This will come absolute means relative means automatically it adjusts to same relative, but absolute will come in the next line. Okay, thank you.